So have you ever tried to sell your product, your service, and it's just not working? Or perhaps it ends friendships, it ceases relationships, it makes it uncomfortable for you because you have burned the visitor, burned the audience because of too much of a hard sell? All right, so let me show you what to do about that. The first thing you want to understand about selling is that it's not about you, it's all about them. Okay, it is not about you. And a lot of salespeople, a lot of people who actually have to sell their product or service, go into a situation trying to memorize the things they want to tell the prospect so they get the message right. They want to go in there and talk about their product or their service and all the benefits. And that's what a lot of people think selling is. And I have a different view. I think it's absolutely not that at all. And I'm going to tell you now how to actually sell the cool way, so to speak, the good way, the right way. All right. So after selling since 2002, I'll be out on my own in 2002, selling via sales, that I then moved on to the stage and to webinar presentations. There's a lot I've learned about how to sell so that it's a good experience all around. Even for those who don't buy, it's still a good experience. And that's what you want in your business if you want to last long term. So here is how to sell without burning your audience, okay? The thing about selling is it's not about you, it's all about them. It's not about your product or service, it's all about their needs. So instead of selling your product or your service, sell instead to their needs. And so what does that mean? How can I help you out? Well, the first thing you want to do is you want to understand who you're selling to. So it doesn't matter whether you have a sales letter or a video or it's in person, it's the same psychology happening every time. So it's about finding out what are the needs of your prospect. Do you know them? And if you don't know them, then you need to find out. So if you don't know them, what could they be? And that's what you want to start and market to. Rather than offloading, selling a product or a service, it's more about actually making sure you know the customer's needs and then tailoring your product or service to suit their needs. And that makes a huge difference. So for instance, if you know that a customer, or let's say a prospect, is afraid of making the wrong decision, and you can find that out by asking them, you know, what would it take to actually have you look at a solution like this? You can also find out what they've purchased in the past, and more importantly, find out the problems they have had with XYZ product or service. Talk about that, actually ask questions, and then also ask questions about what is their goal, where do they see themselves heading? What is the direction they want to go in? What do they really want the most? What are the five problems they want to solve the most? And honestly, you could feel like a 20-minute conversation just with those sorts of questions to find out more about your market, okay? So once you know that, then you know their needs. You know what they need. So rather than you trying to sell a product or a service from your point of view, you're selling it from their point of view and you're selling to their needs. You can talk about how your product or service will actually help XYZ needs. And this is what you want to, this is how you become a solution to a problem. And all selling is really a solution to a problem. If you ever buy something, then it's because that something solved a problem. You might actually go and buy a holiday. Well, that solves a problem for you, right? It solves the problem what to do next time you're having some time off. Or it solves a problem to, you know, in terms of having the family needing to relax or have some fun or let off some steam. It solves a problem. So when you're selling something, you should be asking, well, what problem am I solving? What problem am I really, really solving here? And it's not usually the problem that you think it is. It's usually something much deeper. It's usually something way deeper than what you think it is. As in, there might be a problem on the surface, but below that there is a need, okay? And that is where you need to go to, because the needs drive everything. So for instance, if you were selling, let's say, a coaching program, all right, and you know you have, like, you've got videos to watch, you've got audios to listen to, you've got documents to download, that's what you're selling. But the problem of the customer, or the prospect at this point, the problem they're having is that they can't solve XYZ problem. They're getting up stressed in the morning working, you know, trying to find out how to actually solve this problem of theirs. They're not getting up to buy a coaching program. That's what they're not doing. They're not waking up thinking, I've got to buy a coaching program today. It's all about how do I solve XYZ problem. And if that's what's happening in their mind, then this is where you can come in and you can blitz all the other salespeople out there, all the other opportunities available out there with entrepreneurs and businesses and services, and you can actually just talk straight to the problem which is driven by a need, and this will make your selling so much easier. You can do that in sales letters. You can actually address all the problems that your prospect is going through. And they should be reading your sales letter thinking, that's right, yeah, that's right. And that's because you know what their problems are, okay? And so you can do it via webinar, do it live, one-on-one, to an audience, but it all starts with selling to a need and not trying to sell your product or service, okay? Anyway, that's my view. I'd love to hear yours. I'm Brett McFall, and I will see you online.